मैथमेटिक्स क्लास 12 चैप्टर 6 एप्लीकेशन ऑफ डेरिवेटिव्स एक्सरसाइज 6.4 क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 यूजिंग डिफरेंशियल फाइंड अप्रोक्सीमेट वैल्यू ऑफ द गिवन फंक्शंस गिवन नंबर्स अप टू 3 डेसिमल पॉइंट सो नंबर 1 इज स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ 25.3 नाउ हियर वी हैव सी दे आर नॉट गिविंग यू द फंक्शन सो व्हाट यू हैव टू इज फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट यू हैव टू फाइंड द फंक्शन डिफाइन द फंक्शन सो यू हैव टू फाइंड स्क्वायर रूट सो यू हैव टू डिफाइन फंक्शन y इज इक्वल टू स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ x सपोज दे हैव आस्क्ड यू क्यूब रूट देन यू डिफाइन क्यूब रूट ऑफ y इज इक्वल टू क्यूब रूट ऑफ x ओके इफ दे हैव आस्क्ड यू x पावर 1 बाय 5 देन यू डिफाइन x डिफाइन फंक्शन y इज इक्वल टू x पावर 1 बाय 5 ओके सिमिलरली वी हैव टू डिफाइन व्हिच एवर root is asked okay so I have here square root so I will define y is equal to fx equal to square root of x okay then you have to you need to use this formula okay which I have given you last time so x plus delta x so I will write instead of x x plus delta x square root of x plus delta x that is f of x plus delta x now see here when the value is given I have to find the square root of 25.3 that means near to this number I have to find a number whose square root will be perfect number now 25.3 then I have to see near to 25.3 the number whose perfect square root is found I know 25 if I take the square root of 25 is 5 okay we know that so I can say this divide 25 into 3 I will divide into two numbers one will be x equal to 25 and I have to find that delta so I will take at 0.3 sum of these two should come this much okay or difference of this should come this much So I take x equal to 25 and delta is equal to 0.3. Okay, so remember that first, if I have to take y, then I will select according to what value I have to find, and x will be taken approximately number whose square root. If I have to find square root, if I have to find cube root, then whose cube root is perfect. Okay, so similarly we have to select the number x and delta x will be the sum of the two will be the given number. So from there, or sum or difference, so you can find the delta x from there. So now here I'll take x is equal to 25 into delta is equal to 0.3 because these two combinations should be 25.3. Then I will differentiate this y is equal to root x differentiate with respect to x. Differentiate of y is dy by dx. Root x is d by dx of x power 1 by 2. X power n you use so 1 by 2 x power 1 by 2 minus 1. So it comes 1 by 2 x power minus 1 by 2. And this value is 1 by 2 root x. So that is the dy by dx. Then this is another formula which I have given you delta y is equal to f of x plus delta x minus f of x. This value you put here, this value and this value you place here. Put the value of f x and delta x. So I have put in the value what I have assumed. This comes to be 25.3 and this square root of 25 is minus 5. Then I need to find delta y. This value is the one I have to find. So delta y and 5 make together. So minus 5 transfer plus 5 and call it number 1. Okay. Now this statement is also I have given you that dy is approximately equal to delta y and it is given by delta y is for approximately equal to dy equal to dy by dx delta x. This is the formula I gave you last time. Dy by dx value is 1 by 2 root 2 put here and delta x you are assuming as 0.3 put 0.3 okay x value you put 25 simplifies and then when you simplify square root of 25 is 5 so you get 0.3 by 2 into 5 0.3 by 10 so you got 0.03 now this value delta y you found put in equation number 1 here so I put from equation 1 this is as it is equal to delta y plus 5 so delta y is 0.03 plus 5 add up you get 5.03 so that 5.03 so that is the value of square root of 25.3 is approximate value of this is 5.03 okay 3 decimal but here only 2 decimal you get Roman number 2 square root of 49.5 see now here 49.5 so I have to find square root so what I will define y as square root of x okay and I have to find 49.5 so near to 49 whose square root is perfect number so I know it is 49 because square root of 49 is 7 then 49 minus 49.5 so remains 0.5 so delta x will be 0.5 this sum should be this much or this difference should be this much Then differentiate this part. So I differentiate dy by dx. This differential is 1 by 2 root x. Then this formula delta y is equal to f of x plus delta x minus f of x. This value put what we have assumed. This value what we have assumed here. Put the value of x and delta x. So here x plus delta x 0.5. sum of this, that comes to 49.5, square root of 49, which is 7, transfer here becomes plus 7, call it number 1. Now delta dy is equal to delta y, approximately equal to delta y. Therefore dy and dy is equal to dy by dx delta x. Okay, so therefore put the value dy by dx is put this value point this one 1 by derivative 1 by 2 root x into 0.5. So you simplify, put the value, you get the value as 0.5 by 14. Put in equation 1, so what you get is 0.5 by 14 plus 7, add up 7.035. So that is the approximate value of the given function. Roman number 3, point square root of 0.6. So here also 0.6. So I will take, you can consider 0.60. So I'll take x equal to 0.64 and delta is equal to minus 0.04, because 64 minus 0.04 will come 6 or 60, and y will be fx equal to root x. So f of x plus delta x equal to square root of x plus delta x. As usual, differentiate this, so 1 by 2 root x, use the formula delta y is equal to f of x plus delta x minus fx, put the values, you get is delta y is equal to square root of 0.60 minus 0.8. So 0.06 equal to delta y plus 0.8, call it number 1. Then dy is approximately equal to delta y, and it is given by dy by dx into delta x. Dy by dx is 1 by 2 root x, and delta x is minus 0.04. Simplify, you get minus 0.02.8. Put this value in equation 1, so you get 0.6 equal to delta y plus 0.8. This delta y value, you place it, simplify, you get 0.775. So that is the approximate value of square root of 0.6. Question number 4, 0.009 power 1 by 3. Okay, so see here 0.09, so I will take the number whose cube root is found. So cube perfect, I can take 0.008, its cube root is 0.2. So I will take 0.08 as x, and remaining is 0.001, that I will take as delta x. Now here you see, here x 0.9, cube root I have to find. So what I will take, y is equal to x power 1 by 3. Okay, differentiate with respect to x, so 1 by 3, x power 1 by 3 minus 1. It differentiation is 1 by 3, x power 2 by 3. Then f of x plus delta x equal to x plus delta x 1 by 3. Okay, delta y is equal to f x plus delta x minus fx. Put this value as square root of x plus delta x minus square root of x. Okay, sorry, it's not a square root, it is cube root. Okay, so you have to put here power 3, power 3. Here also power 3, here also power 3. Here also power 3. When you take power 3, this comes to be 0.2. Transfer this side, it becomes plus. Okay, here also will come 0.3. Okay, because I have to find cube root, not the square root. Okay, it's a mistake. Now call it number 1. Then dy is approximately equal to delta y, so delta y is equal to dy by dx into delta x is equal to delta x 3 into x power 2 by 3. Put the delta x value 0.01, x value 0.08 by 2 by 3. See, now this is 0.2 cube is 0.08. Okay, so this cube and this cube 1 by cube cancel, remains square, and 0.2 square is 0.04. Okay, numerator says it is 3 is as it is. Simplify, you will get 0.083. Now from equation 1, put this value in equation 1. Equation 1 is here. Okay, so you put in this delta y value. So when you put the value, you get 0.208. Question number 5, 0.999 power 1 by 10. So I take x equal to 1, delta x equal to minus 0.001. Then you take fx equal to x power 1 by 10. Then x plus delta x will be x plus delta x 1 by 10. Differentiate this, so 1 by 10, x power 1 by 10 minus 1, it comes to be 1 by 10 into x power 9 by 10. Now delta y is equal to f of x plus delta x minus fx is equal to x plus delta x 1 by 10 minus x 1 by 10. Put all the values of x and delta x, so what we get is delta y plus 1 minus, this value will come to be, what is the question, 0.999. Okay, then we know the delta y is approximately equal to dy, and dy is given by delta y is equal to dy by dx delta x. This is the derivative I put here. Delta x, I'm assuming, is minus 0.01. Simplify, you get minus 0.001. Put this value in equation 1. Equation 1 is here, so instead of delta y, place this value. So I put here and I get 0.999. Okay, so that is the approximate value for 0.99 power 1 by 10. Question number 6. 15 power 1 by 4. Here 15, I have to find 1 by 4. So I'll take fx or y is equal to x power 1 by 4. Okay. And near to 15, the number whose fourth power is perfect number, that is number 16. And if I take 16, then delta x is minus 1. Okay. So now this after taking, I'll differentiate. So 1 by 4, x power 1 by 4 minus 1. Take LCM and simplify. So come 1 by 4 x 3 by 4. Delta y is equal to f of x plus delta x minus fx is equal to x plus delta x 1 by 4 x power 1 by 4. X value, delta x value you place. So what you get is delta y plus 2, 15 power 1 by 4. Okay. X is 16 and 2 power 4 is 16. So 2 power 4, so 1 by 4 and 4 cut. So you get 2. That 2 I am transferring the other side. Now delta y is approximately equal to dy. So delta y is equal to dy by dx delta x. Put this value delta y by delta x is 1 by 4 x power 3 by 2 and delta x is taken as minus 1. Simplify, you get minus 1 and 16 can be written as 2 power 4 and 3 by 4 is at the 4 4 cut 2 cube. 2 cube is 8. So I have written here. Okay, see here 2 cube 8. Take in the numerator or divide by 1, you get minus 0.031. Put this value in equation 1, that is instead of delta y. So I put here. Okay, see you put here. So when you put, simplify, you get 1.968. Just simple difference it is. So that is the answer for question number 6. Question number 7. 26 power 1 by 3. So I take x as 27 and delta x as minus 1. And I'll assume y is equal to x power 1 by 3 and x plus delta, f of x plus delta x is x plus delta x power 1 by 3. Differentiate with respect to x, this one. So 1 by 3 x power 1 by 3 minus 1 comes to be 1 by 3 x power 2 by 3. Then delta y is equal to f x plus delta x minus fx is equal to x plus delta x power 1 by 3 minus x power 1 by 3. Put the value of x 27, delta x 1, 27 power 1 by 3 will be 3 cube and 3 cube divide by 1 by 3, so remains only 3. And that 3 I am transferring towards this side. So delta y plus 3 equal to 26 power 1 by 3, equation 1. Then delta y is approximately equal to dy. So delta y is equal to dy by dx into delta x. Dy by dx is 1 by 3 x power 2 by 3 and delta x is minus 1. Put x value, simplify, what you get is minus 0.037. Then put this in equation 1, so you get 2, equation 1 is here. So instead of delta y, we put this for minus 0.037 plus 3, you get 2.962. That is the approximate value of cube root of 26. Number 9. 82 power 1 by 4. So I will take 82. So I will take x equal to 81, delta x equal to 1. Then y is equal to x power 1 by 4. F of x plus delta x is x plus delta x power 1 by 4. Okay, now differentiate this. So 1 by 4 x power 1 by 4 minus 1 equal to 1 by 4 x power 3 by 4. Delta x is f of x plus delta x minus fx. Put the value of x and delta x. So what you get is delta y plus 3 equal to 82 power 1 by 4. Call equation 1. Then delta y is approximately equal to dy, therefore delta y is equal to dy by dx into delta x. Put the values, so when you put the value, what you get it? 1 by x power 3 by 4 into 1, here x is 81, 81 power 3 by 4 means 81 is 3 power 4, 4 4 cut, so 3 cube, that is 3 cube is 27 into 4 divided by 1, 1 by this, so you get 0.0092. Put this value in equation 1, that is 82 power 1 by 4. Equal to delta L y plus 3. Delta y value you place this, simplify, you get 3.009. Question number 12. 26.57 power 1 by 3. So I'll take x equal to 27 and delta x equal to minus 0.43. Fx is equal to x power 1 by 3. F of x plus delta x equal to x plus delta x power 1 by 3. Differentiate this 1 by 3 x power 2 by 3. Delta y is equal to f of x plus delta x minus fx, x plus delta x power 1 by 3 minus x 1 by 3. Put x value, delta x value, 27 minus 0.43 power 1 by 3 minus 27 power 1 by 3. Cube root of 27 is 3, which I am transferring here becomes plus 3. Call it number 1. Then delta y is approximately equal to dy, so dy is equal to dy by dx into delta x. Put all the value, dy by dx is 1 by 3, x power 2 by 3, delta x is minus 0.43. Simplify, what you get is, you have to put the value of x, 27, 27 is 3 cube, so 3 3 cut, so remains square. Simplify this, you get minus 0.0159. Put this in equation 1, here. So when you put, you get 2.984. ओके क्वेश्चन नंबर 14, 3.968 पावर 3/2, सो आई विल टेक एक्स इज इक्वल टू 4 एंड इट इज 1/2 ना, सो आई एम टेकिंग एक्स इक्वल टू 4, सो 4 क्यूब रूट स्क्वायर रूट इज फाउंड, दैट्स व्हाई आई एम टेकिंग नियर टू 3, 4 इज द नंबर हुज स्क्वायर रूट इज फाउंड एंड रिमेनिंग माइनस 0.32 विल बी डेल्टा एक्स. देन वाई इज इक्वल टू एक्स पावर 3/2, डिफरेंशिएट दिस, सो वी गेट 3/2 एक्स पावर 1/2 एंड एफ ऑफ एक्स प्लस डेल्टा एक्स इज एक्स प्लस डेल्टा एक्स पावर 3/2. यूज दिस डेल्टा वाई फॉर्मूला, पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस एक्स प्लस एक्स वैल्यू डेल्टा एक्स वैल्यू हियर ऑल्सो एक्स वैल्यू हियर यू विल गेट 3.968 पावर 3/2 एंड एक्स इक्वल टू यू राइट 4 स्क्वायर 2 स्क्वायर इज 4 सो 2 कट 2 क्यूब रिमेन्स 8 ट्रांसफर हियर बिकम्स प्लस 8 कॉल इट नंबर 1. Then delta y is approximately equal to dy and dy is given by dy by dx delta x. Dy by dx is 3/2 x power 1/2 into delta x is minus 0.32. Here we have assumed. Okay. So that you place. Put the value of x, that is 4. So 4 is square root of 4 is 2. So multiply all this, you get 0.96, but it is negative. Put this in equation 1. Equation 1 is this. Put delta y value here. So you get of 7.04. Then 32.15, 1 by 5, number 15. That is the last in the question number 1. You take x equal to 32, delta x is 0.15. So fx is equal to x power 1 by 5, f of x plus delta x is equal to x plus delta x power 1 by 5. And this differentiates is 1 by 5, x power 4 by 5. And this formula I have given you, fx plus delta x minus fx, put the value x, delta x, so you get this much. And 32 means x 2 power 5 is 32. So I'll write 2 power 5 and 5 cut. So this answer is 2. This answer you transfer here becomes delta y plus 2, call it number 1. Then we know delta y is approximately equal to dy. So dy is equal to dy by ds. Put the value dy by ds, 1 by 5 x power 4 by 5 and delta x is 0.15. X value is 32 and 32 power 4 by 5. So write 2 power 5 and 5 cut. So you get 2 power 4. Simplify this, you get 0.0018. Put in equation 1, here instead of delta y, you put this value. So when you put this value, you get 2.008. So that answer, that is the approximate value of 32.15 power 1 by 5. Okay. So we will keep this much. In the next class, we'll continue with question number 2. This method is simple. Okay. First, you have to define the function fx. From what you are asked to find. If you are asked to find square root of any number, then you take fx as a square root. If you are asked to find cube root of any number, then take cube root as the function. If you are asked to find the fourth root, then take fourth root as the function. Okay? Then you have to take the number which is given, near to that the perfect root of that number. Okay? And then delta x will be remaining there. And then use the formula. Dy by dx first differentiate and dy is equal to f of x plus delta x minus fx. Using these two formulas, you have to find the approximate value and you can do it. If you cannot, please let me know. I'll explain to you. Thank you very much.